City Council has approved a contract extension for a controversial law enforcement tool. The decision to continue to use facial recognition in Detroit, the measure passing by a 6-3 vote this afternoon. The $200,000 contract covers maintenance, upgrades, and technical support for the software used by Detroit police. Officers say the software reduces crime and helps get violent criminals off the street. But those who oppose the use of the technology say the software is racially biased and often inaccurate in identifying people of color. The new contract will run through September of 2022.
And on tonight's 7 Upfront, Detroit Mayor Mike Duggan joining us with the latest development and other issues affecting the city. Mayor Duggan, thank you for being with us tonight.
Thanks for having me.
Well, let us start with that facial recognition technology and the City Council's decision to extend that contract. Do you agree with the decision?
I congratulate City Council. They overwhelmingly approved it for the second time. A year ago, the Board of Police Commissioners overwhelmingly approved the policy. And they deserve a lot of credit because there's not been an issue in this town that the media has more misrepresented than the facial recognition policy. Nobody's arrested off of facial recognition. It just starts an investigation. And council members deserve credit to drown out the noise and go by the facts. We've taken some very bad people off the street with a very responsible use of this technology.
So you feel like it works just fine, Mr. Mayor? I mean, even though we're seeing that uptick in crime in the city, is it a deterrent? Is it helping police?
So here's what the facial recognition process does. We had, for example, a triple homicide in the LGBT community on the east side of Detroit. And when you get a picture, let's say you were at a gas station and we get a photograph and we aren't sure who you are, the Detroit police take that photograph and they run it against the pictures in their mug book. There may be 40 or 50,000 felons and the like, but they run the pictures through and the software says, here's 5 or 6 people with similar facial features. At that point, investigators at headquarters look at it and say, do these look similar? If they find somebody that looks similar, they then start an investigation. Who is this person? Do they live by the site? Do they have a motive? Do they have a weapon? If you were assaulted in the old days, you go into the police department and they give you a mug book and you would page by hand, page after page, trying to find people who look like your perpetrator. What this does is dramatically speed up the process, but nobody's arrested off of it. Under the Board of Police Commissioners policy, all that happens when you've narrowed it down is you start the investigation at that point, and that's why City Council was supportive today.
Okay. All right. So even those who feel there may be mistakes in identity, you say this is just to start the process.
Since the Board of Police Commissioners approved this policy a year ago, which the head of the Obama Civil Rights Division for Police Investigations has called the model policy for the country. Since the Board of Police Commissioners put this policy in place a year ago, there's been no claim of any misidentification. There were problems very early on when the software first came in. The Board of Police Commissioners and the Detroit Police Department learned from it. And I think everybody who's gone in and looked at this and done the tour comes away very impressed. There was one case where they had a drive-by shooter and they had a picture. They ran it through facial recognition, found a possible match. When they went to that person's Facebook page to see if he might be the person, he was sitting on the getaway car with a gun in his hand on his Facebook page profile. This is what you do. It starts the investigation. It isn't the basis for an arrest.
All right, Mr. Mayor, thank you. Let's move on to COVID-19 and the impact that it has had on the city of Detroit and the budget in particular. We know what your office did to prepare, to help us prepare for this virus. But how are you dealing with a tremendous loss in revenue?
Well, fortunately, the city of Detroit did so well financially coming out of bankruptcy because people have come back and businesses have come back far faster than anybody projected. We had significant reserves. And so we have had people go on furlough, go from working 5 days a week to 4 days a week or 3 days a week to save funds. We were able to use those reserves. We just finished our last fiscal year, June 30th, with another surplus for the sixth straight year. And we're going to be okay in this year. It took some belt tightening, but we were preparing for a recession, and we responded to it, I think, well.
Okay, thank goodness. Mayor Duggan, you know, an amazing announcement, that $48 million public and private investment. Talk about how those funds are going to be used to address housing instability in the city.
Well, you've seen a lot of places in the country where new people move in, new jobs move in, and those who had lived there get priced out of the market, get forced out of their homes. We said, we're not going to have that in the city of Detroit. We're not going to be Washington, D.C. We're not going to be Brooklyn. We're not going to be Seattle. Our commitment is that those who stay through the hard times are entitled to be protected and stayed as things come back. And so every time somebody builds new apartments in this city with any kind of city help, 20% of those apartments are set aside with permanent subsidies for affordable housing, so people of all incomes are in all neighborhoods. And we want to build more affordable housing. And today we raised $48 million from the private sector. JP Morgan Chase came in with a $50 million contribution, Kresge Foundation with $10 million and a number of others. We're going to use those to build affordable housing to make sure that we want people coming into the city. That's a great thing. We're going to make darn sure we protect those who stay.
And that is so important, Mayor Duggan. We are out of time this evening, but I thank you so much for spending this time with us tonight.
Thanks for having me on.
All right, Dave.